So, what is it that helps you to handle any situation? Yes, your mindset. How present you are. What is your observations? What is your thought process? What actions you are going to take? How you are going to react to the situation? Yes, mindset plays a very, very important role in dealing any situation, and even more important for agile teams, because with the right mindset, they are able to handle, the dynamic situations so beautifully. They are able to traverse through the troubled waters. It's not a calm sea, it is the troubled waters, and they are skilled to navigate through these troubled waters. Yes, with that, we are going to start our module 3 of chapter 1, which is the foundation for PMI ACP exam prep. And this chapter is dedicated to introduction to agile. And who am I? I am Nidhi Kohli with EduHubSpot. I am a PMI ACP trainer, and we have helped several people ace the PMI ACP exam. So in our last module, you saw we covered the first six principles and four agile values. This particular module is going to be dedicated on the last six principles, which is principle number 7 to principle number 12. So what are we waiting for? Let's get started. So principle 7, for those of you who have not listened to my previous video on values and principles, I would just give an overview of how I am explaining. With every principle, my first slide, I am going to highlight the key points within the principle. This is the principle. These are the key points. In the next slide, I am going to give you some practical tips on how to achieve it, and I recommend you to go and implement this principle in your day-to-day life, in your professional environment, maybe in your personal environment, wherever you can. And the last third slide of each principle will give you a summary or a focus area. So let's go back to the principle 7. And if you have not already heard the video, seen the video of Agile Values and Principles, and the very first video in which we tell about what Agile is, how it was conceived, and all those things, I would recommend you to please go back and listen to those videos. But for now, you should continue listening to this. Once you are done with this, go back and look at the previous two videos of this chapter. Okay, they are extremely important. You can get them from our YouTube channel, which is EduHubSpot. Okay, with this name, you can see. You can also find them on our website, which is www.eduhubspot.com. Okay, so let's get started with principle 7, which is working software. So this principle talks about working software is the primary measure of progress. Yes, primary measure of progress is working software, which means software which is usable and which is delivering value to the customer. Okay, that's what we should be delivering to the customer, and that is the primary measure. Imagine your customer wanted an apple, okay, and you delivered an orange. Orange. Okay, this doesn't look like orange, but it is an orange. Okay, so he wanted an apple, you delivered an orange. This is eatable. Yes, you can say this is usable, but is it valuable to the customer? No, right? He does not want any citrus fruit, he wants apple. Okay, so usable and which brings value to the customer is what our working software means. Okay, both usable, both valuable to the customer. Okay, and that's how we will measure our progress. And see, when we deliver in small chunks, we deliver the most value to the customer. Customer looks at it, he uses it, do some hands-on on that product, on that delivery, and he gives us feedback. And when we give feedback, this is a moment which is a learning opportunity for us, which tells us, are we on the right track or do we need to do some course adjustments here? Okay, so feedback is always a learning opportunity. So what are the practical tips here? We should keep our iterations small, okay, so that we are able to deliver working software. Okay, in each iteration, we pick up user stories which are of highest value to the customer. Okay, highest value, and these user stories should be small. Okay, why? So that we can demonstrate them, we can test them, and they are providing some value to the customer. Okay, imagine a user story which is implemented across two iterations. Then after the end of first iteration, do you have anything to deliver to customer? No, right? So we make our user stories in such a manner that they can be delivered in one sprint or less, one iteration or less. Okay, and if a user story is big, you need to decompose it. Okay, all the deliveries are based on done criteria. This is definition of done. Okay, and if you have to read about it, listen about it, you have to go to our website www.eduhubspot.com, register, create your account, and listen to our remaining videos on PMI ACP exam prep. Yes, your PMI ACP tutorials are available at our website. So go ahead and listen to them. Focus area for the team is iteratively and incrementally deliver value through working software. Okay, so we have to deliver in small chunks, small iterations, you know, something which is valuable and which the customer can use it. Okay, and that's how, when he is able to use it, he can give us feedback. Okay, early feedback always helps agile teams to be on the right track. Okay, this ensures that agile teams are building the right product. And in next some of the principles, you will see they build the right product first time right. And this part is being taken care of in the upcoming principles that we are going to talk in this particular video only. Okay, so principle 8. Principle 8 is about constant pace. Constant pace, which means the team is going to, they are not exhausted. They are able to maintain their pace. Okay, it's not that they get overwhelmed. No, they are not overwhelmed. So they are not exhausted, they are not overwhelmed by the amount of work which is there, they are not confused. You know, when people get overwhelmed, they get confused. They are able to deliver high quality software, okay, continuously. And how does that happen? How does that happen? When we promote sustainable development, okay. So agile processes promote sustainable development. The sponsors, developers, and users should be able to maintain a constant pace indefinitely. Yes, that's when the work-life balance is there. Okay, and what are the practical tips for it? Work at a steady pace. Cut the waste. Do not spend time doing things which are unnecessary. Okay, we don't want to spend time there. Maintain work-life balance. Okay, work and pleasure, they go hand in hand. In fact, if you look at Agile values and principles, you will see that Agile teams, they love their work. Okay, they love their work because it is such a positive environment and it is such a supportive environment that everybody likes to come to the office. They like to work on these projects and they celebrate their successes. They celebrate their successes together. Okay, so it is such a positive environment that the team enjoy, Agile teams enjoy working on Agile projects because Agile processes promote sustainable development. Life is a marathon, okay, and not a sprint. And this sprint is not the scrum sprint. This is the, when we run quickly for some time to be able to reach the target. Sometimes it do happen that team has to work extra or to be able to meet their commitments, but that is not a norm. Okay, it is maybe there are cases when they have to do it and they are willingly, they will be doing it because overall the environment is such that, once in a while, if it has to be done, it has to be done. Okay, but this is not a norm. So Agile teams believe in work-life balance. Agile teams believe in working at a steady pace. Why? Because they want to ensure that they are running at a constant pace indefinitely. And how do they do that? By cutting the waste, by not focusing on things which are not important. See, one example is time boxing. Remember time boxing? If not, go to the chapter Planning, Monitoring and Adapting. Listen to the video. It is explained in detail. But time boxing helps the teams to focus on the task at hand. They don't waste their time on unnecessary discussions. Okay? And how do you achieve it? Work only as many hours you can be productive, can sustain and be satisfied with the effort that you have put in. And Agile teams, they take pride in their work, okay? And they, not just in their deliveries, in the qualities of the deliveries, okay? So they really take pride in their work and that is why they value work-life balance because they know when they are happy, when they are motivated, their balance is there, they will be able to deliver quality software. See, imagine if you are, you have to come to office for 3 weeks in a row. Okay, all days and you were working 14 hours per day. Imagine. See, it can happen. It can happen when you are working for, 14 is too much, maybe 12 hours a day. Okay, 12 hours a day, 21 days in a row. What would be your situation by the end of it? You will be exhausted and whatever work you are doing, it would be prone to errors, right? So Agile teams understand that by putting in regularly extra hours and if you are not taking rest, if you are not happy with the situation, you tend to do mistakes and these mistakes are going to be costly for you because there will be defects, then you will have to spend some time fixing them. So it's like a vicious cycle, you spend extra hours, you make mistakes, you find defects, you have to fix them, you have to spend extra hours, and it keeps on going and going and going. Let's not get into that cycle, okay? Let's focus on what we are delivering, how we are delivering, and maintain balance in our life, okay? Next is about technical excellence. We just talked about principle 9. So Agile teams, they focus on the quality of the work they are doing, okay? So continuous attention to technical excellence and good design enhances agility. Yes, so you are focused towards technical excellence and good design. which means the quality of your deliverables is very, very high. Okay, so quality is high because you are focusing on technical excellence and good design. And how do you do that? Next principle is dedicated for that, which talks about simplicity. Okay, practical tips: continuously inspect, look at what you are doing and make changes if needed. Look for simplicity. Okay, look for are there ways to improve this further, or are there ways to make it even more simpler? Because see, if things are organized, let's say this is a bookshelf, okay, and the books are like in library, they are well organized as per author name or the book name, let's say, or with the number, which you can see it on their online system. So you can really make out which particular shelf, which wardrobe, which shelf you can pick up the book, or you will find the book. So it's organized. You can just go and pick and bring the book, right? As opposed to another rack of shelves where books are randomly placed. You don't know which book and you have to search from these books. What would you prefer? You would prefer this, right? That is why agile teams focus on technical excellence. Okay, they make their designs simple and easy to maintain so that you can make those changes. Okay, so they continuously inspect the work that they are doing. They ensure they are following guidelines, coding guidelines. They ensure that they are focused towards through reviews. They are focused towards good design. And the design on agile teams is emergent and incremental. We have talked about it in video one. Go ahead and listen to that video one of the same chapter, Introduction to Agile, which you can obtain from our YouTube channel. Go and subscribe to our YouTube channel and you will get access to lots of interesting videos. And I hope you are enjoying this video too. Okay. And how do we ensure we refactor? Refactor is cleaning up of the code. Okay. Keeping the external behavior same. You are not changing the external behavior. Internally, you are cleaning up. Okay, that's refactoring. Focus area: continuous reflect, inspect, reflect, and refactor code to avoid technical debt. What is technical debt? So technical debt is a debt which is technical and which you have accrued on your project. Does it satisfy you? No, right? You have to listen to another video in which technical debt is explained fully. Okay, go to product quality, listen to the video, and you will get to know what technical debt is and what is design debt. Yes, there is a term, design debt. Go ahead. It's along with refactoring. Refactoring is also explained. Okay, next principle is based on simplicity. Simplicity, the art of maximizing the amount of work not done. Maximizing the amount of work not done is essential. You know what? Simplicity is actually based on the concept of essentialism. There are a lot of books out in the market. You can go and read about them. Pretty interesting. So what it says? It says you keep only what is essential for you. Okay? Which means you don't have so many things that you don't know which one to use or which one to keep. Imagine if there is a wardrobe. See, I'm a girl. Okay, I have liking for dresses, so you will hear such examples. So in the wardrobe, if you have, you know, plenty of dresses for summer, for spring, for winters, and in all, you know, you have organized it like this. And here also you have party wear and your sports wear and your casual wear, your office wear. So think about it. Your wardrobe is huge, right? And every time you want to, you know, organize it or maybe remove some, you see, you know what? I like this, even though I have not worn it for 1 year, but I like it. Maybe, you know, let's keep it. Let's keep it. I will wear it. I'll definitely wear it. Let's keep it on top. Do you really wear it? No. So better keep, you know, keep looking for waste. Anything that you are not using, that is a waste. And waste in detail, we have covered in our lean video on lean. Lean and Kanban actually, but it is covered in lean part, but the video name is lean and Kanban. Okay, so that's that you can find out on our website eduhubspot.com. okay, so it's under chapter 2, agile methodologies. So keep things simple and maximize work not done. What does it mean? We don't want to do work? No, definitely we want to do work, but we want to do only what is needed, what is required. Okay, we don't want to do anything extra. Remember the presentation that you prepared, which nobody actually saw or used. Because your boss asked you to prepare a presentation, you spent so much time, gathered all the data, you put across such a beautiful presentation, but in the workshop, this was never even used. Nobody even knew that there is a lot of effort that has gone into it. Happens, right? So don't spend time on doing things where there is a doubt or where, which you think are not going to be used. Of course, you are going to. This is going to be in agreement with your boss. You can't do it just like that. Okay, I don't do the presentations. Practical tips: reduce waste, limit work in progress, which means pick item and focus on finishing that before you move to another one. Okay, so you pick whatever you are picking, you finish and then you move. Okay, and the third is imbibe lean culture. Very important. In fact, the whole agile, you know, is based on the foundation of lean manufacturing principles. Okay, lean mindset, it is a mindset. Okay, so you focus on removing waste. So work only on essentials and remove waste. That's the focus area for this particular principle. Next is self-organizing teams. So what it says is the best architecture, requirements and designs. Basically, best work is done from self-organizing teams. So by self-organizing teams. So best work means best output. And what are self-organized team? The teams who decide themselves, okay, who organize themselves, who decide what to do, when to do, and how to do, okay? They have a priority backlog is there. All the requirements are there, which are in the order. They are ordered, okay? Or as per their priority, they are sorted out. So they pick whatever is the next highest priority and then they decide who's going to do when within the iteration it's going to be done, or maybe it's not going to be done in this iteration, there is dependency or something, you know, and how to technically deliver. Teams decide themselves. And how do we manage that? By building, you know, the mindset for self-organizing team, by empowering the team. Okay, we have to empower team. See, they are the people who are doing the work at ground, right? So they are doing, so they best know about how to handle the situation. Okay, so we should not be telling somebody how to do the work. If we know the person is good, he can handle things, so let him, give him the freedom to do the work the way he or she wants to do. Okay, so empower team. No micromanagement, and have transparency of progress and risk. That's the principle number 11. Focus area, management should empower team, give them the freedom, okay? Give them the authority to take decisions of day-to-day things. Unlike some methodologies in which you have to take approval before doing anything. No, give the team the freedom to make their own decisions. Okay, and when they do that, they take responsibility of their actions. Okay, they take ownership to meet the goals. Right, that's the focus area. And with this, we are at our last principle. Yes, be happy. Last principle, regular reflection, and your foundation with this is going to be complete. And I'm expecting you are already in the agile mindset now. You will start thinking in agile manner. You will be flexible. You will be agile. Okay. So last is regular reflection. At regular intervals, the team reflects on how to become more effective and then tunes and adjusts its behavior. Okay, so what it says, agile teams continuously, regularly, okay, they check how things are going. Is everything fine? Or does it need some improvement? Or can we bring some improvement? Can we improve, enhance, our processes, our behaviors, our work items so that we are more productive, right? So agile teams continuously look for improvement. And based on their reflection, they learn and adapt their behavior. So they implement these learnings right then and there. Okay, right then and there. And there is a practice being used in Scrum for that, and it's called retrospective. So that's just one of the practice. And if you want to read about it, you want to listen, go and see video on Scrum. Okay, so what it is saying, reflect on how things are going, what is right, okay, and where there is a scope for improvement. Introspect and identify lessons, then adapt by implementing those lessons. That's regular reflection, and I would recommend you to read more about retrospectives. Focus area, continuous focus on self and team improvement and process improvement. Okay, with this we come to the end of the chapter. And before we go, I would like to give you a learning tip again here. This is something I have made, so you can make your own. Because the World Cup was going on and we are crazy about watching World Cups. So just to help learning, I made this statement. You can have your own. Okay. She will deliver daily mangoes for World Cup team, so they sizzle and rock. And every first alphabet helps us to learn the principle. Satisfy customer, welcome changing requirements, deliver frequently, daily interactions, motivated teams, face-to-face interactions, working software, constant pace, technical excellence, simplicity, self-organization, and regular reflection. Okay. So now that we have finished the chapter, I would recommend that you go and visit our website. This is our website, and take the chapter test. Okay, for chapter number one, which is Introduction to Agile. Your foundation is strong. Okay, you believe in yourself. You have a strong base now that you understand the thought process behind Agile, being Agile, what it means to be Agile. Okay, so I believe that you are ready to take the test and inspect, plan, do, check, act. So check your progress, your understanding, and take action based on the results. Okay, you can also find it on Android Play Store or Apple App Store. Search for EduHubSpot, and the ACP practice questions and videos is the name for the app. Okay, if you like this video, go ahead and subscribe to our YouTube channel. As and when I add another interesting video, you will be notified, and you can go and enjoy it. It's going to be a good journey for you. I believe that you are going to be successful in your PMI ACP exam certification, and we are going to support in your PMI ACP exam prep. Okay, so go ahead, subscribe to our channel and listen to newer and newer videos. You can also create a login at our website, and there are a lot of resources which you can actually take a look at. There are a lot of other videos also available. So with this, I would recommend that you have a very good reading time. You are set to embark on the beautiful journey of PMI ACP exam prep. Bye-bye. Happy reading.